Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. In this video, we're going to start tearing down the power head on our 2004 Yamaha F225. Now listen, there's going to be no special tools involved with this, so I will call out whatever tool I'm using to start the breakdown process. We're going to pull the cams, get the head off, take a look at those valves, and see if any of this can be reused when we go to rebuild it. So if you're ready, we can go over there and get started. Go ahead and get this mounting plate out of the way, and then we should be able to release the tensioner and get the belt off. So now let's go ahead and relieve tension. The way you do that is put a 10 millimeter in there, pull it slowly, maybe 10 foot pounds, and you'll see the pin start to relax and it comes around. At that point, you can put in your 5 millimeter pin and it'll hold it there. Not that tough. There we go. I'm going to go ahead and pull the tensioner all the way off and just put it to the side. Next, let's go ahead and move this transition plate for the throttle body linkages. Next, let's go ahead and remove the cam gears. You want to use an impact on these because you can't allow these to turn, otherwise you're going to bend your valves. Let's go and get our drive sprocket taken off since we're right here. There's a ground strap running in between the two heads. Let's go and get that out of the way before I forget. And then we're going to pull the valve covers and the exhaust plates and take a look at the top end. Let's go ahead and remove the exhaust plates, and you'll notice that they are numbered 1 through 14 for each side. We're actually going to do this in reverse. 1 through 14 represents the tightening sequence. If you were putting it together, we're taking it apart. So we're going to start at number 14 and work our way down to zero. There we go. Careful when you're doing that, don't damage the surfaces. Ooh. That is not a good thing, because that is getting ready to snap. We will come back to that one later. All right, now back to our problem child. Yep, she broke. There we go. They do give you a point to pry right down at the bottom. Next, let's go for our covers. What I was worried about is that we were going to have damage to the cams caused by oil starvation, because we know that there's evidently an intrusion of the old galleyway somewhere down in the block, to be determined where that is. We won't really know until we get the cam caps off. So before we pull the tensioner and the caps, let's go ahead and pull off the other cover. Prodding. There we go. Now, let's go ahead and start with our tensioner over on this bank. There we go. Now we can take off our caps, so we're going to go one, two, three, four. All right, let's keep going. So that's one, let's get two. The sequence to pull the heads on this side is going to be 1, 2, 3 bolts on the outside. Now the torques on the inside, we go 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And at that point, we should be able to remove it. They're already broken free, so we can just go straight up. All right, once we pull up that last one, the head will be free. We'll still have to break it loose, but keep in mind, there's nothing else holding it except the dowels and the head gasket. See if we can get her to come loose. What I'm looking for here is to see if the head gasket was blown anywhere. It does not appear to be, from what I see so far. We might be able to reuse these, but I won't know until I get them completely broken down and cleaned up. But those two areas might explain why we were losing so much pressure on compression and on the leak down. It looks like it was blown through right there. Remember correctly, if you go back and watch that video, it was this one that had like a 75 or 85% loss on leak down. Let's go and get that tensioner out of the way. There we go. So let's go ahead and start attacking the starboard side, starboard bank. We start up with, on the cam, caps. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we finish with number 5. That is the one cam that didn't have any tension on it with any of the valves. What I'm doing now is just cleaning the oil off the top of the tappets. So I want to go ahead and mark these. I was a little bit lucky on the other side that none of them fell out. I don't want to take that chance over here. So we're going to go ahead and mark them as to what location that they started in. That way they can go back to the same place. So let's go over the loosening sequence on this. So it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. As you can see, I already have all the tappets numbered because we do plan on reusing these heads if they do check out at the machine shop. So we want them all to go back in the same location. So let's go ahead and start pulling them out. I'm just using a magnet to grab them from the side. Now keep in mind, as you're doing this, if you just used a Sharpie to write this on there, one spray of contact cleaner and all that goes away. So you have to be careful when you're cleaning these up. I like to lay them out in the same orientation that they come off. just in case a number gets wiped off. Before we start pulling them out, I just want to do a quick litmus test on this one. What we're going to do is actually spray a little bit of contact cleaner into each port. That way we can see if there's an obvious leak on the valves. So we'll start over here on the intake side and see if any of them are leaking. Whoop. See that one? Now, if you've noticed, I'm wearing gloves as I'm handling this thing because all these edges are like razors and they will open you up in a heartbeat. Let's see what we've got. All right, that's all right. Look at that one. See it leaking? And let's go for the last one. Oop, there she goes. We have at least one cylinder that we know is leaking now. So when it comes time to put this back together, after we've gotten the valves all cleaned up, we're going to put a little bit of Prussian blue. That way I can look at the seats and see where they're actually riding on the valves. And if I have to recut the seats, then so be it. But I'm more than likely, I'll just be able to lap the valves to get them to seal properly. Just a couple of turns, then we can reach in and grab the keepers and then release it. Both of them, one shot. Normally, if I had done that first test and there was no leakage, I'd be really concerned about getting all the valves right back where they started. Well, if I'm gonna have to resurface the valve seats and or the valves, I'm not worried about it so much. I am still gonna keep them organized, but at this point, it's not hypercritical that they all go back into the same place that they came out. Where'd you go? There you are. Well, one down, one to go. You get the idea of the process now. What I'm gonna do next, once I finish breaking down the other one, is go ahead and load them up, take them to the machine shop, let them get them cleaned up and resurface that head, and then we will take a look at the valve seats to see if we can get them to straighten back up. Well, listen, if you need any parts for your machine, why don't you come see us at boats.net and we will get you taken care of. Have any questions or comments? Leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. Hey, if you like what you see, why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button over there? That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on next. Just want to say thank you for shopping here at boats.net and we will see you in the next video. Have a great day.